Welcome to this low back session, everybody. I'd like you to start by resting on the floor with your feet flat, knees bent, and a small object like a yoga block or a folded blanket between the knees. We're going to let the head rest with the back of the neck long. And we'll allow the hands to rest down on the belly, right along the intersection of the lowest ribs and your stomach. And just take a moment to tune into your feet. Feel your feet along the floor. Feeling your toes. Feeling your heels. Just relax in your feet. Taking your awareness up to your knees. You should feel very comfortable here. At ease. And just applying gentle pressure to continue to hold on to the block or the blanket. And releasing the back of the waist along the floor. Feeling the ribs on the floor. Relaxing your shoulders back and down. And keeping the head released. And then let's just connect to a few full breaths here. Two more slow, deep breaths. Just take a few moments and completely relax. Okay, so now we're going to transition out of this shape. So you're going to need one chair for this movement. For a really nice low back reset. You've been cooking this one for quite a long time, too. One chair. Support your calf. Leg at a 90 degree bend. And one leg straight along the floor. And all you need to do is relax into it. So what we're really doing is over a long, slow melt in this pose, letting the hip flexor, groin, psoas, quad, the entire front of this long left side, letting it relax. Trying to force, really push or exert, just relax into it. Let the full weight of your body, especially the back of your waist, your hips, your pelvis release. Your arms just find a nice comfortable shape. Relax your head. So a good time to just tune into your breathing.
And let's simmer here for one more minute. Switch sides. Just as you would suspect. Let the new leg extend out. New leg up on the chair. Oh. Find a nice comfortable spot for your arms. And give it a little time. Again, we're just sensing into the back of the hips, the back of the waist, and the back of the ribs. And just letting them all soften. And feeling a gentle stretch and openness across the front of the thigh, psoas, and hip flexors. Let's just spend one more minute here. And remember, we're cooking here for just a few minutes in this session, but you can lie in this pose for 10, 12, 15 minutes. I don't think I want to come out of this pose, but we're going to switch gears. All right, so next we're going to move into a little bridge sequence. Lift. Lower. with these bridges, you want to press down evenly through your feet, left and right, and really propel the movement with your glute muscles. So pressing down with your feet, pressing up with the back of your hips, opening up through your thighs, and releasing back down. Okay. Now on the next half dozen, we're going to do a little reach with a rotation. So I'm reaching the right hand across to the left. And I'm reaching the left arm up and over across to the right. Let's try about 10 of those. It's 5 more. So really pressing down through your feet, activating through your hips, but twisting. Head stays on the ground. Last two. Do a sideline exercise. Prop up on your head, or let your head come down a little lower. You're going to reach the leg back and up. And tap it forward. We'll try 10. So first she goes back, ribs stay strong, and then you lift to your maximum up. So cues here, you want to take, you want to maintain strength in your torso, so your ribs stay tucked in. You want to keep your tail running down your backside. And remember, it's dual components, backward extension through your hip, behind the plane of your spine, and then upward, keeping good form. And you might feel a restriction really early in the upward lift. You might be able to go pretty high. Last three. Last two. Last one. Change sides. So it's backward and upward. Legs straight. Torso strong. Head can be wherever you like it to be. Supported up like this. Or down like this. Just behind the line of the spine. And then up. Last five. It may burn a little, but it's usually very productive. Oh, goodness. Okay. Next. We're going to lie prone, just belly down. Now, as you lie prone here, you just want to take your feet about hip-width distance apart. Really relax the front of the hips and the waist and the pelvis. Soften the backside. Soften through the pelvic floor. Relax your belly. And then what we're going to do for about 10 deep abdominal breaths, just let the head lie on the hands. So as you lie face down here, I'm going to turn so you can hear, but you keep your head face down. Tune into your breathing. Let your back relax. Just maintain a very gentle version of extension. Last few breaths here. Finally, we're going to come back into a supine position on our back. Extend out through your legs. 1 minute. Squeeze your glutes. And relax. Squeeze. Relax. Squeeze. Relax. And these squeezes can be strong and active. As much squeeze as you want to create. You're holding for 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 seconds. Should be pretty robust work. And then you're softening for 1 or 2. So, in general, additional glute strength is a wonderful way to help your low back feel better. It's both a long-term solution and a short-term solution. So for chronic low back pain, this is just in general, getting the glutes to fire more tends to be very, very helpful. And sometimes, even when you're in acute discomfort, actively squeezing the glutes can be helpful as well. So Let's just try one more strong squeeze. And then let it go. And lastly, we're just going to rest in Shavasana. And take your awareness down to your feet. And just relax your toes. You don't even have to do anything to relax them. Just imagine them softening. And feel the weight of your feet on the ground through your heels. Feel the air against your skin or through your socks. And allow the legs to just be relaxed and heavy here.
Hey, Gabe?
Yes.
Can I hand you some
dishes? Sure.
Are you teaching?
I'm filming, just for myself. That's okay.
You can tell
me, come
down and get her book.
I'm almost done.
Okay.
Shoot. Feel relaxation through the backs of the knees. All the way up into the back of the hips and the back of the waist. Feeling your sacrum settled on the floor. And just sensing cohesiveness amongst all the inner organs. Softening the ribs. Letting the heart be open. And feeling that relaxation through your shoulders, down the backs of the arms, into your hands. And finally moving the awareness up to the neck, the crown of the head. The face. Just allowing the crown to feel open. And that space between the eyes to feel open. And letting the rest of the face soften. Extra. Shavasana. Corpse pose. everybody. So, reconnect to your breathing. Time making that transition out of Shavasana up into a comfortable seat. All right, everybody, I hope that felt good for your low back. Namaste.